staying with us. This is You Special, and we're still here at the Hindustan University campus. And we've been talking about the young Indian leaders of today and whether they're really going towards a situation of doom. I want to ask you at this point, you know, whether do you think our leaders who are young today are really walking the talk?
I really don't think so, because if you take the example of Rajiv Gandhi, as he's been the talk of us right now, so it's like he basically is only seeing the education firm. Our country does not need just education. You've got to see the population again.
Then again, you're referring to Rahul Gandhi.
Rahul Gandhi.
Right. Okay.
He's being on a campaign regarding educational among the poor people and all.
Right.
At the same time, if you see, you say they are poor. Why are they poor? Again, you got to keep in consideration. You got to considerate the population of the country. Control the population again. And then again, if you say that these guys, the politicians and all, they say they want to be one of us. They go, they have dinner with the poor people, they have lunch with the poor people, they have meals with the poor people. At the very, you know, they come in convoys of cars, they say simplicity in life.
Traveling in a Mercedes.
Yeah, they say, you know, just be as simple as possible. Traveling in a Mercedes, crossing crores, traveling in an Audi, again crossing crores. It doesn't make sense. You know, you want to say simplicity, travel in a Maruti 800. Where, you know, 5-seater, you have 10 people traveling. You actually then know what the life is. And then again, if you see the vibrancy of the population, we are not just country of people of just one class. We have the richest to the poorest.
Absolutely.
So if you got to keep everything in consideration. You look at the health firms. It's, you need health. You need education, which is, okay, slowly things are coming up. But then it's just not that. The poverty, you know, you don't have to just bound yourself to the thoughts of what's just around you. You got to go into all... You know, the narrowest curves possible, you know, the narrowest streets and all.
Right.
You know, person to person, he knows what life is. Those people sitting in the AC office, hitting the benches, fighting out themselves, amongst themselves, it doesn't make sense.
Okay. You want to add to that? But I also want to ask, you know, whether, now that we've been talking about young leaders and all, what is the age gap by which you say, okay, that is a young leader? Do you judge by a certain age?
Okay, first off, no, young leader can be, you know, responsibility actually kicks in.
Is it in the mind or is it in the age?
It's all in the mind. You know, okay. You can, you know, find really young people who are very mature and vice versa. So, okay, let's say like 25 to 50 as, you know, young people, because, you know, they actually have to fight it out in life. And like what he said, you know, Rahul Gandhi is just focusing on education. I don't think he's heard of this phrase called knowledge is power. Empowerment is the start of all reform.
Right.
So what Rahul Gandhi is actually trying to do is empower the people.
You know, he's actually maybe going to the root of all the problems.
He's going to the base of it.
Okay.
Once working bottom up is always the best part. You know, working top down, you know, doesn't exactly achieve anything. And again, you know, he traveling in his Mercedes and all that. See, his family was already rich, way before, you know, India got freedom. Okay, so he's spending his money how he wants it. He's not spending the people's money. But what he's actually asking the people to do is he actually lived with the people. In UP, he's been with the people. He stayed in a village. He didn't, you know, after the village, maybe he went back to his own lifestyle.
Yes, and how many of the leaders today do you see doing something like
that? Yeah, how many of the older leaders actually can find that?
I just want to counter this. I would just want to ask you simple questions. How do you know it's his money or is the public's money that he's actually having with him?
Well, I guess only he will answer that, right? That's a very difficult question.
See, before every elections, you know, the politicians have to declare their assets.
Right.
Yeah. And they also have to declare how they got their assets, like immovable properties or movable properties.
What do you have to say about you know, the raids and all, when you have 400, 500, 4,000, 500 crores being collected from the same politician's
friend,
house?
You're talking about Rahul Gandhi and, you know,
no,
young
just
leaders.
Now you just mentioned politicians.
Yeah,
so
politicians.
I'm just Rahul talking Gandhi. In general.
In general, see, there is
when
corruption.
You have raids
corruption
and all,
is
you look at Mayawati herself. She is from a middle.
You don't find Mayawati doing the
Would
same thing as
Rahul. Would you consider Mayawati a young leader?
No.
No, okay. So she's
but
out of
she,
question.
I mean, Mayawati is old enough to be my grandmother,
okay,
so
okay,
I don't know.
More point of view, yeah. What is your idea of a young person? Do you think there should be also, while you have a young person, maybe from 25 to 50, at the same time, do you think there should also be a retirement age?
Yes, ma'am. There should be a retirement age, I think from 50 to 55. Because, like, you should give chances to other people also. I mean, there are so many young leaders in our country. So unless there's a retirement age in our country, the young leaders can't come to the camera. I mean, they can't really analyze the situation. So I think the probable age would be 50 to 55.
Okay. Now, before we wrap this discussion, I want to pose a question to maybe each of you. Tell me if you would actually go back to your constituency and, you know, take up this post. Now, obviously, you know, it's a difficult task, heading a country, heading a constituency, heading a region. There's so much. There's corruption. Our country is tainted with corruption, price rise, inflation, so much that you need to really look forward to. But you guys want change. So are you willing to take the step?
Yes, ma'am, definitely. I would stick to your
point. Are you willing to give up, you know, a possibly a good fat-paying salary job that gives you maybe out of recruitment of out of Hindustan? Give that up and maybe go ahead to a village somewhere in the heart of the country?
Yes, definitely. Is, you know, like the spirit of nationalism, it's among, you know, like why we sitting here is because we have that spirit within us. And for that, like, I would like to share an experience. I went to the NSUI headquarters. Mm-hmm. I went to the NSUI headquarters and I inquired how to participate, you know,
right.
for the youth politics and what to do. And what they said was really disheartening, because they told me that you have to actually, you know, quit your college in Chennai. You have to come to Assam and then you have to, you know, participate. You can participate actively here. Then I asked them why. This is a national movement. So why can't we, you know, operate from Chennai? Why can't I help?
Right.
No, they said you have DMK in Chennai. You have this and that in Chennai.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, like what I saw was, it's a regional picture, you know, like it's regionalism.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the politics has been regionalized, you know, the leaders that are, you know, they are all regionalized. So what I want is, you know, like youth today should get united, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It should be like one nation, one country breathing together.
Right.
I mean, breathing in one breed, and, you know, just the one motto that we have to develop our country.
Okay.
It's not about, you know, regional politics. It should be about the nation itself.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that's what, you know,
okay.
I think.
I think that's a great note to end on. That kind of a motto. Sabrina, I want to end from you on this side. You are from Kashmir. Do you think maybe people like you could maybe do a better job than Omar Abdullah, or he is leading by example?
I would say he did a better job. When he started, we were all so happy that finally we have a person with a red tie, bright red tie, coming to office, all crisp white shirt and all that, made good roads. I'm telling you, the development in Kashmir was massive. But like I said, the first point that I had made, the experience counts.
Right.
He couldn't handle that situation. So I would just like to say that politics and youth go hand in hand completely.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot have a political movement without youth. Our country's past says that, our independence says that, but governance and youth don't go hand in hand. For governance, you need that experience, you need that expertise, which only a person who knows the game, the ball game, that's politics,
mm-hmm.
can do.
Okay.
I think that's
okay. Let me see a quick show of hands. Okay, how many of you think that's all the time we have? But I'll just let you give me a show of hands. How many of you think that the young leaders of today are really doomed in a country like India? There's no hope at all. Okay, how many of you think there is still hope? Okay, I think that's pretty much balanced. It's a mixed response. But I hope that you have that spirit alive in you, and that there is some hope as youngsters of today, that there can be some change at least for our nation somehow. And you work actively in wherever you go. Thanks so much for being a part of You Special. It's been a pleasure talking to you guys. If you'd like your gang of friends or your college to take part in You Special, all you have to do is shoot me an email to feedback@ndtv-hindu.com, and we'll be there on your campus and we'll discuss about something that's in the news soon enough. This is Evelyn Matthews signing off from the campus of the Hindustan University. Goodbye for now.